Hey everybody, it's Jang here with a look at the LEGO City 2016 police sub-theme, Crooks Island. So the police get their prison island this year and the crooks get their own little island hideout. I like the look of this setup here. It has a nice balance between the repurposed shipping container over on the left-hand side, some simulated natural terrain with the rock formation over here on the right, which is mostly one single large corner piece, but they put just a few little things on it just to make it a little bit different from the base, but it works just fine. And then the kind of man-made structure area, hut kind of thing in the center, or shed, with a little bit of pier here, so you just imagine there would be water around here, shallow at first, and then it gets deeper fairly quickly. And small little details on here with the texturing on the front. One sticker on the door, of course the door can be opened up. Little lamp here, little chimney on the top, and then a simulated vent on the top. Just small little details that go a long way. You see there's a water scooter or a jet ski inside of the shipping container. I love this shipping container because I really like these pieces, these large textured kind of corrugated steel style pieces, especially in olive, and I appreciate that they brought some olive across the top of the thing as well with these tiles and also the grill pieces. But the scooter inside of there has a little bit of a action feature that really comes from a little assembly on the back of the container. Take the thing out, put a person on it, put it back in, then you're actually ready to make a quick getaway. The idea is that you would have a person on there and you hit a lever back here, a handle. Depending upon how hard you hit it, that'll determine the speed that your jet ski comes jetting out. So that just went completely off screen, but this is a fairly basic build, has three stickers on it, but I'm glad that it has at least the one on the front because it gives it some unique flair there. It just holds one single figure, as you would expect. Around the back, you can see the mechanism is very simple for hitting that thing. It's just one of these angled Technic beam pieces doubled up and just basically has a little kind of track in there to get the thing to go, you know, just shooting out through the front. With the use of the large piece here, the single large piece over on the side, it gives you extra space here, creates a cave, and that's actually intentional. The idea is that you could use that as some hiding space where you could hide away some goodies, that, you know, some stolen goods, since they're crooks. For stolen goods, they have a safe here, and the figure has what LEGO describes as a welding torch. I think it's supposed to be a cutting torch. The idea is that this guy's trying to get at what's inside of that safe. And if the police find them, then he needs to hide that away in here. And you have to just imagine that there's more here. You know, it's the typical kind of cutaway scenario that LEGO frequently does. They have a little bit of a furnace over here to provide some heat. And there's a wanted poster that's up just to remind them of how dangerous what they're doing really is. And you've got some small accessories over here on the side with the flashlight and the clock, obviously, and then the always necessary coffee maker. The way this is built, the container is actually attached to the main structure with just a couple of Technic pins. So if you wanna separate this out and reorder and reorganize things, you know, kind of change the shape of it all, you can, you know, close up the back like that, but it does leave a little bit of an ugly face there and even more so here. The police, balancing things out, get a helicopter here, so they're going to be patrolling around looking for the hideout of these criminals and where they keep taking all these safes that they're stealing from banks and from people individually. This is actually a solid build, even though it does, once again, use that same canopy piece that they have used so many times that, to my eyes personally, always make all helicopters that use that piece look the same. They really look the same, even though this has a, like I said, it is a good build. It's a solid build. Has a nice centered, single stud wide tail. And of course, you always have the, you know, rotating parts. A little bit small on the main rotor here, but nice detailing around the side. We have a clip on one side, and I especially appreciate that this one has a ball joint used for the camera, so the camera can be, you know, pointed in absolutely any direction. That's a, you know, it's just an improvement over what they've done in previous years where they had just a single axis or two axes that were separate. You're Cockpit area is really simple, just has the single control stick, and that's it. And then there's no access to space back in here because it's all brick built. But like I said, to me, pretty much any helicopter that uses this canopy ends up looking like just all the other helicopters that have been made using that same canopy. Here's a closer look at the three figures included, with the female criminal on the left, who I like very much for this year. The one in the center is a prison escapee, and I appreciate the fact that he's got a little bit of a different than normal body shape than they usually do. And then on the right is just your helicopter cop, right? Your chopper cop. And yeah, no alternate faces to be seen on any of these, but there's what there is to see on the backs of the torsos. I pretty much covered my personal thoughts about each part of this set as I went through demonstrating, but on the whole, I kind of wish that this had a smaller, less substantial helicopter, or maybe even a smaller watercraft for the police, just to have a little bit more balance over towards the bad guy's side. You know, maybe a little bit bigger build there, or a few more details. Share your thoughts about the set by leaving a comment on the video down below, and I'll talk to you again soon. Thanks for watching.